When it comes to the Boeing 787, the long-haul widebody has two families of engines that airline customers can choose from when an order is placed. Airlines and or lessors can choose between the Rolls-Royce Trent 1000 family of engines and the GEnX engine from GE Aerospace. Conventional wisdom would have carriers pick one or the other and stick to that one engine maker to power all of the 787 aircraft in the fleet. With all 787s in an airline having engines from one company, maintenance and logistics are simplified and streamlined, leading to reduced costs and complexity. This has been the case for many airlines. Just to name two examples, all of United 787s are GE-powered, while all of Singapore Airlines Dreamliners use Rolls-Royce engines. However, over the years, a number of carriers have diversified their 787 fleets in terms of engines. In fact, a number of carriers see Rolls-Royce Trent 1000-powered 787s operating alongside those powered by the GEnX. So, for today's video, let's look at which carriers fit this category and if this leads us to a noticeable trend or pattern. One of the first airlines to add engines from the other company was Air New Zealand. The carrier has been operating a fleet of 787-9s powered by Trent 1000s. However, in May 2019, it ordered 8 787-10s to be powered by GE. As AirlineRatings.com stated, Air New Zealand had, quote, turned its back on Rolls-Royce by selecting General Electric engines. It was noted that Air New Zealand had suffered significant disruptions to its operations due to durability issues surrounding the Rolls-Royce Trent 1000, a saga that many cite as the reason for the carrier's change-up. There may be more to the story, however, and that's something we'll cover later in this video. But when it comes to other airlines, less than a year later, Japan's ANA, All Nippon Airways, made a similar move. In February 2020, during the early days of the global health crisis, the carrier announced its intention to acquire up to 20 more 787s. ANA already had a large 787 fleet, and so it made sense that the airline would expand with this aircraft type. However, it pulled the same move as Air New Zealand. The 2020 order would be powered by General Electric's GEnX engine, where previous jets were powered by the Trent 1000. In December 2023, LATAM announced an order for 5 787s. With the new order, the company said it would equip these 787s with GEnX engines, and yet again, existing 787s with LATAM were powered by the Trent 1000. LATAM Chief Financial Officer Ramiro Alfonsin said the incorporation of GEnX engines was a decision that would provide greater flexibility and options for the expansion of the long-range fleet. And then just a few months later, in February 2024, Thai Airways ordered 45 787s at the Singapore Air Show, and you guessed it, these would be equipped with GEnX engines. Again, Thai's decision was a move away from the Rolls-Royce Trent 1000 engines, which are fitted on its current fleet of 787s. Most recently, British Airways joined others in ordering 787s powered by GEnX engines, where its existing 787s had Trent 1000s. The order was for 6 new Dreamliners. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to see at least one pattern here. Airlines that were previously committed to Rolls-Royce and the Trent 1000 were, and are, willing to diversify their 787 fleets with Dreamliners powered by GE engines. Interestingly, we haven't really seen airlines go in the other direction, ordering new 787s powered by Trent 1000s while operating an existing fleet of GE-powered Dreamliners. With 5 airlines making this move, it's no wonder why GE boasts that its GEnX now powers about 2/3 of the more than 1,100 787s in service. It just seems to be the more popular choice. And so, what could possibly explain this trend? Well, the leading explanation is that many airlines were badly burned by Trent 1000 issues experienced between around 2017 through 2020. The crisis resulted in prolonged groundings of 787 fleets, restricting airline capacity and even forcing some carriers to wet lease jets. It would be quite understandable that airlines were or are dissatisfied with what happened, especially when considering the fact that GEnX has not had issues to the same extent as the Trent 1000. Yes, these GE engines have had a number of airworthiness directives, but nothing as widespread as what Rolls-Royce had experienced. But is there more to the story? Well, according to Forbes, yes. Other factors may have been included in the decision. The outlet noted in 2020 that the 787-10 could only fly with the Trent 1010 and not earlier Trent 1000 variants. Rolls-Royce was redesigning the 1010 but did not expect it to be ready until 2021, and this didn't even factor in time needed for certification and manufacturing. At the time of making this video, we know that around August of this year, Rolls-Royce began flight testing of the new blades. And so perhaps timing may have been something ANA was looking at. Additionally, it was noted that performance deficiency could have swayed airlines towards GE. The Forbes article asserts that Air New Zealand and Scoot found the Trent 1010 falling short on fuel burn on the 787-9. And so airlines may have been more attracted to the performance characteristics of the GEnX, particularly when it comes to the stretched 787-10. It is, however, important to note that we haven't received any specific comments from airline executives on this topic. However, the situation with Thai Airways does offer us a few more details. According to airporttechnology.com, the decision to choose GE Aerospace engines over Rolls-Royce was due to an ongoing dispute between the engine manufacturer and Thai Airways. The CEO of Thai Airways, Chai M. Siri, wasn't happy with Rolls-Royce as he believed that the company was attempting to maintain higher prices to raise revenue. The engine manufacturer had shifted its practice of offering significant discounts under current CEO Tufan Ergin Bilgic. Instead, the company's focus was on short-term profits over the potential of long-term contracts with operators. The airline executive was quoted as saying, "You should never play hard to your customer. If you play hard, you may win in the short term, but lose for the long term." M. Siri had previously threatened to move to an alternative supplier due to the dispute, and in retrospect, he made good on that threat with the recent 787 order. So, that's the situation in late 2024. We have at least five airlines which were once tied to Rolls-Royce and the Trent 1000 for their 787 engines, but are now integrating new GE-powered 787s into their fleets. It's not a great look for Rolls-Royce, but hopefully it can get its improved Trent 1010 engine and engine blades certified soon in order to be more competitive with GE's offerings. So, what do you think about this situation? Do you think we'll see more Trent 1000 operators entertain the possibility of adding 787s with GEnX engines? Let us know your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.